To live in the victory. I'm not going to live in the negative. I'm not going to walk around with doubt as if God's not going to do it. But I'm going to trust God because I know who he is and what he can do. Can I get a witness here? And because I have victory, I'm always speaking victory. I don't ever want defeat to come out of my mouth. I don't want to talk like a defeated soldier, but I want to talk like somebody that's got victory. Can I get a witness here? And Lord, you hear some people talk. You think they got a whole lot of stuff, but they don't have it yet. But they're speaking as if they already have it. Can I get a witness here? And that's where I want to speak. I want to speak to the positive. I don't have it, but I'm going to talk like it's already mine because I am a possessor. I don't have it yet, but God's going to bless me. Can I get a witness here? I'll speak with so much faith. People are going to ask me, when did I get it? I tell them I hadn't got it yet, but that's the way my faith is. My faith speaks for me. It speaks in advance about what God is going to do. So I can't look at the circumstances and the things that I'm going on, but telling them I want to speak by faith and I want to speak in victory of what God is going to do. Somebody clap those hands and help me give the Lord a praise in here. He would always pick some real good fights. Can I get a witness here? And he would always tell them, if you hit me, I'm going to tell my brother. And they didn't even know who I was. And they said, I don't care who you tell. Can I get a witness here? So they took their swing and then it came back. And he said, guess who hit me? I didn't even care what the name was. I said, show me where they at. Can I get a witness here? And by the time I showed up, they was ready to apologize. I said, no, we're too late for that. We're past apologies. We're past pleasantries. It's now time for me to join in and extract revenge on what you took that didn't belong. I wish I had somebody here. Can you grab your neighbor and say, neighbor, we in this thing together. What he does to the least of us, he does to all of us. And I'm not going to let the devil pick on my brother. I'm not going to let him pick on my sister. I'm not going to let him pick on my kinfolk. Can't mess with my family. Can I get a witness here? That's why when David showed up with supplies in the Valley of Escalon, he said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that challenges the army of the living God? I want to know who he is that think he can talk that way and breathe out threats against the people of God. Can I get a witness? And I come to tell you, the devil has crossed the line. Now he's talking like he don't know who we are. Tell your neighbor, I'm a child of God. And if the enemy can't respect that, we're going to have to teach him respect. Because anytime you fool with a child of God, it would be better that a millstone be tied around your neck and cast in the sea than to offend one of my little ones. Can I get a witness here? We need to fight back against the enemy. God said, start fighting. And if you feel like you can't make it, I'm going to send you victory. So here 232 men look like little kid goats in the midst of 100,000 horsemen. Lord have mercy. And the Bible said that they fought till they couldn't fight anymore. And the Bible said the Lord joined in into that fight and killed off 100,000 men in one day. And the 27,000 that retreated ran from the fight, went inside the city. God caused the walls to fall down on the rest. 232 men killed off 100,000. And those that thought they got away, God caused the walls of the city just to fall on them. Lord have mercy. With 232 men, God brought victory to the people of God. Because the enemy crossed the line, demanding things that wasn't his, saying he can do stuff that he couldn't back up. Do I have a witness here? And saying what my God can't do. All those factors worked against the enemy, and they worked in our favor. So no matter what the devil says, he's still a lie. He's always been a lie. And all he's going to ever be is a lie. So anytime the devil tell you what God's not going to do, you ought to start rejoicing. He ain't going to bless you with a thank you, Jesus. What made the devil say that? Because he know what God can do. So he's trying to defeat me before I get the victory. But the problem is I already have the victory. So when the enemy talks, he literally talks too late. He's always saying what God's not going to do, but you're saying, but he's already done it. You're not going to have that. He's already blessed me. He's not going to do it. He's already done it. And the devil says, how, when, where? I'm speaking by faith because now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence.